you could get on there and bulldog that one. It's got plenty of horns to grab a hold of.
Broadcasting.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yep, I okay. Sure can. How okay. Are you?
Pretty good. I had to mess with my Y here real quick to be able to hear you, but can you still hear me, Daisy? Is it still jumping over there? Because suddenly I'm getting nothing on here, but you can still hear me okay? And you can hear Janet too? Okay. Okay, say something, Janet.
All right, testing, 1, 2, 3.
Okay, she's got testing both of us. She's got both of us, good.
Okay, good. Okay. Hey, what I did was, hold on a second.
Okay.
I put all those interviews, I transferred them in so that, you know, I could just play it out of the live screen and everything.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
Okay, well,
so anyway,
I haven't decided which ones I'm going to use yet because one of the guys from Mid-Continent Livestock is actually here.
Oh, good.
So I can talk with him live.
Okay.
One of the guys from the stockyards is going to visit with us, so I can talk to him live. So we may only have to play like one or two of those interviews to fill time.
Okay. And then, you know, I've got all of those ag reports in there, you know, like AgriAmerica report that, you know, downloaded this morning and commodity settlements. And so I've just got all that stuff in there. So wherever you want me to jump, we'll jump.
Okay, that'll be good because what I'm thinking about doing here is I'll have you put us on the air. I'll come on and say hi, hello, tell everybody where we're at, go over the weather. There is a sale coming up next week here at Fort Scott. I'll talk a little bit about it. One of their special cow sales, so I'll talk a little bit about it. And then, let's see, those brownfield reports, how long are they? Are they all about the same length, or are they different lengths?
They're different lengths, but they're pretty close, though, like the AgriAmerica report.
Right.
That's 3 minutes. Then you've got the commodity settlement, which it talks about Friday's close. That's 3 minutes.
Okay.
Let's see, I've got closing farm break. That's a couple minutes. Let's see what else. Final commodities, 4 minutes, you know, morning ag, it's afternoon ag headline news, which closed down yesterday.
Okay.
It's about 2.5, so, you know.
All right. I may have you do one of those 3-minute ones then, like either that commodity settlement from yesterday, the last one yesterday, or the agri break, either one, whichever one you want to run, it doesn't make any difference. And then that way, that 3-minute break will let Daisy run some of her commercials on the web TV side of things.
Okay.
And she can get some of those taken care of right off the bat. And then I may come back and let's see. I was trying to think. I could jump.
Then I've also got, like, the Joplin Regional Stockyard ad, you know, in and the Evans Pipe and Steel and, you know.
Just regular spot.
I just have all that, I've just got all that stuff kind of sprinkled throughout with pauses and everything. So I can jump back and forth however you need me to.
Okay. That'll work. I may just, after we take that initial report, and that'll let Daisy run some of her stuff. Then I may come back and just kind of go over where we're at again and say, hey, and Dwayne got here. And then just run a couple of ads or something like that, Joplin Regional or whatever, run a couple of ads.
Okay.
And then come back and talk with Jeff and that should get us pushed through a little bit, because somewhere around 12:10, 12:15 is when the guy from the stockyards is going to come visit with us. And if we have to, if we have to play one of our interviews in between, we can. If not, I can visit with him. And then that way, the last half hour, we can play some of our interviews and stuff then.
Okay.
I need to look.
And what I did is I put a pause in between all the interviews so that, you know, if you wanted to come back and talk for a couple of seconds or, you know, whatever, and then go back, you know. So I've just got them all broken out.
Okay. All right. I'm just kind of looking.
A pause in between each one. So
two that I'm looking at that I'll probably try to play today, and because they're one of them's in this neck of the woods at Lamar, is the Compton Irrigation guy, and then then I may try to do that Big John Manufacturing as well, because he does a lot of business in this type of country and crop country, and I mean I know we're over in the edge of cattle country too, but those two are kind of, they would do a lot of business here in this area, so.
Okay, that's great. And that's a, Big John, as you know, is 9 minutes and 9 seconds,
right.
And Compton's 7.5.
Okay,
so
that'll work good. And then the guy from Mid-Continent Livestock, he sells protein tubs and livestock tubs, which is good for the cattle. And so he's actually here, and I'll talk to him while he's here. So.
Great.
All right. I guess you got everything ready on your side, Daisy? Okay. I guess it's already after 11:30 if you want to find a break.
You want to start playing the Farming in the Four States intro?
Yeah, you can play the intro and throw it to us.
Okay. All right. I've also got the streamer on, too.
Okay.
So.
Okay.
Okay. All right. So hold on just a second. All right.
I'm now for Farming the Four States here on KRMO AM 990, your ag voice in the Ozarks. Whether you're full-time or part-time or involved with livestock, crops, or agribusiness, this show is for you and about you. Farming the Four States on KRMO AM 990, Ag Source Radio.
All right, ready in 3, 2, and one.
And good morning, everyone. Welcome to a special edition of Farming the Four States here on KRMO AM 990, your ag voice of the four state region. Sammy Clapper with you here today, and we are live on the road as we kick off our Seven Barns in 7 Days tour today, and we are in Fort Scott, Kansas at the Fort Scott Livestock Market. We're very pleased to be with you here today. Special Saturday edition of Farming the Four States on AM 990 Ag Source Radio. As Seven Barns in 7 Days starts today. Next week, we're going to be very busy. We're going to be at Joplin Regional on Monday. Next Wednesday, we'll head down to Green Forest, Arkansas. Then Thursday, we head up I-44 to Lebanon, Missouri, to Mid-Missouri Stockyards. Next Friday, we'll be back down in Arkansas at Springdale. And then the following week, on Wednesday, we'll be at the Springfield Livestock Marketing Center. And then on the 16th of March, we will wrap up the Seven Barns in 7 Days at Coffeyville, Kansas, at the Coffeyville Livestock Market. We do appreciate everyone for tuning in today, and we look forward to telling you what's going on today here in Fort Scott, Kansas. It is sale day. They have their sales every Saturday here at Fort Scott, and it's a very busy place. We are live in the sale ring, and you can probably hear the auctioneer in the background. Cattle being run through and being sold. They've been doing that since 8 o'clock this morning, and they will continue throughout the afternoon selling cattle all day long here at Fort Scott. We're also streaming live video today of the activities here at Fort Scott Livestock Market. You can go to either krmo.com and then click on the Farming in the Four States logo. And when it takes you to that page, you'll find a spot to click to Web TV, which will take you to the Farming in the Four States channel. Or you can go to citylinktv.com. And in the Missouri section, you'll see Farming in the Four States. You click on that link and it will take you to the channel, as we are streaming live video today at Farming in the Four States Web TV. We also have live streaming audio today at RadioTalon.com on the KRMO page, and then live here on the air today on AM 990. So lots of different ways to view all the activities and listen to the activities here at Fort Scott, Kansas. First of all, we'd like to thank the folks here at Fort Scott for having us up today and appreciate them being part of our Seven Barns in 7 Days tour. Randall Redinger, the general manager, met us this morning, got us all set up and ready to go, and we appreciate all his hospitality and help. And we look forward to being here for the next hour or so, visiting with you from Fort Scott, Kansas, at the livestock auction. Appreciate Janet back at the studios getting us up and on the air today. Thank you so very much to her. And Dwayne, he brought us the books. The Stockman's Record, Seven Barns in 7 Days books are here as hot off the press. They just were printed up and finished up earlier this week. And the new Stockman's Record books, special Seven Barns in 7 Days edition, we have them here today as well. They've got the new VFD section in there for your veterinary feed directive information. They've also got the breeding and calving information pages as well. There's a page in there with all the livestock markets throughout the four-state region, their sale dates and their contact information. And then there's a special section in the back of the Stockman's Record, the special Seven Barns in 7 Days edition, that has a little short bios about each one of the stockyards we'll be visiting over the course of the next week and a half. So you can find out a little more information about them. And then, of course, the Stockman's Record, Seven Barns in 7 Days edition is jammed full of sponsors and advertisers that all deal with livestock, ag, the ag industry, technology, insurance, family planning, estate planning. It's all right there. All types of great information and a great resource to use. The Seven Barns in 7 Days edition of the Stockman's Record from KRMO Ag Source Radio, and we will be delivering those throughout the four-state region to sale barns throughout the area, and the first stop of the Seven Barns in 7 Days is here in Fort Scott. Beautiful day in the four-state region, a little windy, but the temperatures are warming up. We've got 62 degrees in fair conditions, the humidity's at 29%, but the winds have already picked up out of the south-southwest, 15 to 20 miles an hour, gust up from 25 to 30 miles an hour. And with the low humidity, the warm weather, and the high winds, that means the red flag warning is in effect for today throughout the area. Please no outdoor burning. Dry weather, we haven't got as much rain as we would like to have received this time of year. And even though there was a few storms went through earlier in the week, the windy and low humidity conditions have dried things out real quick. And we do encourage and ask that please no outdoor burning, as the red flag warning is in effect from now until 7 p.m. this evening. So fires will get away from you in the blink of an eye with the winds and the low humidity. So no outdoor burning today with these very windy conditions. Gusts are going to be up around 35 miles an hour later this afternoon. It's going to get warm today, up around 70 degrees, only down to 50 tonight, back up into the mid-60s on Sunday. And clouds are going to come in Sunday afternoon into Sunday evening. Then there's a chance of rain Monday into Monday night, and maybe a pretty good chance of rain. National Weather Service is saying 80% chance of rain Monday night. So hopefully we'll be able to get some beneficial rains out of this system that is coming through our area. But warm and windy today, and again, please no outdoor burning, as that red flag warning is in effect until 7 p.m. this evening. Again, we're live at the Fort Scott Livestock Market. Sales got underway at 8 o'clock this morning. The auction will continue throughout the day, and we're glad to be here today as part of the Seven Barns in 7 Days tour. Just a reminder, coming up next Thursday, March the 9th, Fort Scott Livestock Market will have a special cow sale. Rockin' R Ranch will have a complete dispersal. They've got all types of offerings, 17 black fall pairs, 120 black and red cows with 75 calves. The rest are springers. Crone Brothers will have 100 black, red, and Charley cross cows. Also consigned to that special cow sale next Thursday, March the 9th here in Fort Scott. 45 black cows, 15 black cows, third period, and then several bulls as well. They've got pasture-raised bulls. They've got limb flex bulls, a couple of black Angus bulls, and they all have the one-year breeding guarantee. So that's a special cow sale next Thursday, March the 9th, beginning at 6 p.m. here at Fort Scott Livestock Market in Fort Scott, Kansas. Fort Scott Livestock Market started back in 1994, and since that time, they have surpassed over 2 million, over 2 million head have been marketed here in Fort Scott, Kansas. So since 1994, over 2 million head have run through the livestock market here in Fort Scott. They've got all types of offerings available. They have the auction every Saturday beginning at 8 o'clock in the morning. You can bring your cattle in on Friday. They got feed and water pens. They can truck your cattle if you need some arrangements getting your cattle hauled here. They can handle that as well. They do on-farm appraisals, and they load or unload actually 7 days a week. If you've got a day that you need to get some cattle here, you can bring them 7 days a week. They do the video auction here. They're on DV Auctions at Fort Scott Livestock Market, so live video auction on DV Auctions as well. And, of course, we're right here on the edge of the Flint Hills, so a lot of cattle country just to our west and northwest, and that's all here in Fort Scott, Kansas. They're the fourth largest market in Kansas and one of the best markets here in the four-state region. Fort Scott Livestock Market, you can find them online at fslivestock.com. That's fslivestock.com. And any of the folks here will be more than happy to visit with you about the services. They've got a busy sale going on today, and you can see live video of that sale by going to the Farming in the Four States channel, either through our KRMO.com webpage or by going to CityLinkTV.com and search for the Farming in the Four States channel. So, again, they've been selling a lot of cows here. We've seen a few younger head, some heifers, and some steers go through. A lot of cows and bulls have been going through here in the last hour or so. Now, the way they start things, they usually start with the slaughter cows in the morning, and then they go to the bred cows and pairs. Then they get to the breeding bulls, and then they start calves and yearlings, and then they'll go into other cattle as well. That's the selling order of the livestock. So they start with the older animals and then go to the younger as they start the sales every Saturday morning here at 8 o'clock. It's a family-owned and operated business, and we're going to talk to one of those family members a little later on here in the show. Sometime a little after noon, between 12 and 12:30, we're going to be visiting one of the Martin family, and they have several generations working here at the livestock market. We'll be looking forward to visiting with them. Right now, we're going to take a little break here. We're going to check in with one of the Brownfield Ag Reports for you and get caught up what's going on today in the world of agriculture. So a Brownfield Ag Report coming your way next. It'll also give us the opportunity to mention and recognize some of our sponsors on Web TV as well. Then we'll come back, catch up on what's going on here, and looks like we might be, during this next break or the one right after, visit with Jeff Anslinger from Mid-Continent Livestock Supplements. Now, we're going to be hearing a lot from Mid-Continent Livestock over the next week and a half as they are one of our sponsors of our Seven Barns in 7 Days tour. And we've got some pre-recorded interviews with those folks that we'll be playing for you on our days that we are at the stockyards. But Jeff actually made the trip here to Fort Scott today, so we're going to be looking forward to visiting with him live in person. Sammy Clapper along with you here today. Special Saturday edition of Farming in the Four States. Daisy Kaya is running the camera for us today on Web TV, and we appreciate her help also. And we'll be looking forward to continuing our broadcast here today at Fort Scott. Seven Barns in 7 Days kicks off today in Fort Scott, Kansas, and we'll be continuing through next week. But right now, a word from Brownfield, and then we'll be back here at Fort Scott, Kansas.
Hey folks, Sean here at the Concrete Works. We're located at the end of the rainbow, and we do things the old-fashioned way. We mine our own gravel, we batch our own concrete, we build our own custom forms, and every day we put the concrete into the forms. Your cattle will be happy campers eating out of our field bunks, line bunks, wide J bunks, commodity feed bunks, and freeze-proof stock tanks too. We'll bring them to your farm on our own locomotive, and remember folks, that ain't no bull.
Okay, we're getting into the Evans Pipe and Steel ad, and we have about 30 seconds. If you
Seven days tour here on KRMO AM 990. We kick things off today. We're in Fort Scott, Kansas at the Fort Scott Livestock Market. They got their sale started at 8 o'clock this morning, and they are currently selling cows and bulls still, and then they'll go into the younger livestock after lunch. So a busy day here at Fort Scott, Kansas. We do appreciate the folks having us up today, and looking forward to getting our seven barns and 7 days tour underway. We're going to be at four sale barns next week. And then March 15th and 16th, we'll wrap up the Seven Barns in 7 Days tour at Springfield Livestock Marketing Center and also at Coffeyville, Kansas. But today we're here in Fort Scott. And again, they've been in business since 1994, and they're running through cattle all day long here today. I was talking with Randall Redinger earlier today, and he said they'll probably sell cattle all the way up until 5 or 6 o'clock this afternoon and into the evening. They're expecting around 2,500 head here today. And one of our sponsors of the Seven Barns in 7 Days tour is Mid-Continent Livestock Supplements. Now, the Seven Barns in 7 Days Stockman's Record Book, you can find them at your local sale barn. We'll be delivering those over the course of the next couple of weeks. And you're going to be hearing a lot about Mid-Continent Livestock Supplements. We've recorded some interviews and going to be playing those for you. But we're very pleased to be actually here today with one of the folks from Mid-Continent Livestock, and that's Jeff Anslinger. He's actually made the trip to Fort Scott, Kansas. And, Jeff, we appreciate your time.
Thanks a lot. We appreciate you guys doing this, and we appreciate being here. So.
You've had a busy week this past week, like I'm going to have next week. You and I were talking before we jumped on the air. You've been attending a lot of conferences and seminars, relaying about Mid-Continent Livestock Supplements to the producers here in the four-state region. And we appreciate you taking time to drop by and visit with us here today, because sale day is always a very busy day at the livestock auctions. And that's one of the reasons why we wanted to be here on sale days at the livestock auctions, because it gives you a chance to see more people and visit with a lot of folks.
You bet, and who doesn't want to be at a cattle sale on Saturday? I mean, you know, most of us probably in the ag industry probably grew up working at a sale barn on a Saturday, you know, when there were still a lot of them around, so there's no better place to be. So,
well, you and I got to talk on the pre-recorded interview that people are going to hear next week, but we are glad to be with you here live today. And tell us a little bit about Mid-Continent Livestock to refresh everybody about what the supplement and the protein tubs are all about.
Well, we're a family-owned company. We've got three manufacturing plants, one in Moberly, Missouri, one in Ellendale, North Dakota, and one in Valley Mills, Texas. All we do is low-moisture blocks, molasses-based, low-consumption blocks. We've been in business for close to 30 years now. We're Missouri-based. It's fescue-based product, so it's going to work. You know, you're going to get complete vitamin and mineral supplementation, plus a little kick of protein for your cows to get them off right. We've got a great stress and receiving tub, great breeder minerals, products for all species of livestock. We've got a new horse tub coming out with Clarifly fly control in it. We're one of two, I think, companies that have got that product in there for horses. So we're really looking forward to seeing what that's going to do for us this year.
And that's one thing. We're here today talking cattle at Fort Scott, but you have protein tubs for a variety of livestock.
You betcha. We've got it for sheep, cattle, horses, goats, you know, for everything. So
you can find out more by visiting their website, mlstubs.com. That's mlstubs.com. And that's the protein tubs have really become very popular, especially with cattle producers, because they're so convenient. You can put them where you need them, when you need them there. And you and I were talking when we recorded the interview. Some people have been using them to coax livestock to different parts of the pasture that maybe not be utilized as much as other times. So they're just a great product to have and a tool to use with your cattle operation.
They are. You know, you don't get the boss cow syndrome like you do on loose mineral. You know, all the cattle can get to it because they've done some studies to show a cow go to it an average of 3 to 5 times a day to get her on, as in our case, a third to half pound consumption on them. So, you know, you don't get that boss cow syndrome. You can move them to where you can control the grazing patterns of the cattle. If you've got a spot to where they don't go too much because the grass might be a little bit tougher or something like that, put that tub there and they're going to go to it. It's going to save you time. It's going to save you expense on equipment. You know, we'll give you a mineral feeder with every tub you buy, and it's returnable. So there you go. So,
Are they all one size, or what are the different sizes you have?
We've got several different sizes. We've got a 200-pound tub, 125-pound tub. Then we've also got a 60-pound tub. And in the horse buckets, we've got a 25-pound bucket for one individual horse in a stall.
And to be able to put, like you said, the fly control medication and things of that nature in there to go along with it, that just saves time as well, because it's kind of those one-stop being able to do several things.
You bet. Yeah, we can add the fly control. We've also got a new product called Selmanax that we're using that's got a moss product in it that'll bind pathogens during calving time, pass on colostrally to the calves. It's going to bind the E. coli, the salmonella. It's also got a yeast culture to aid with gut health and some beta-glucans and stuff to help block toxins and aid with digestion and things.
Again, we're visiting with Jeff Anslinger from Mid-Continent Livestock Supplements, protein tubs with proven performance, and you can find out more by visiting their website, mlstubs.com. And how big of an area, you talked about where several of your plants are, but how big of an area do you actually cover?
I cover part of Missouri, part of Kansas, southeast corner of Nebraska, and some of Iowa. Our company, if you'll go draw a line from Ellendale, North Dakota, from the North Dakota-Canadian border down to the southern tip of Texas and go about two states either side. We do some business up in Vermont on some dairies. So we're branching out farther to the southwest or southeast.
So what a lot of people visualize as the entire Midwest region from north to south, you guys pretty much cover that territory, don't you?
Exactly, yeah.
It's not just the four states, but you guys have a great influence right here in the four-state region too, and part of that's because of all the livestock we raise here.
That's true. You know, you talk about, you know, you can draw a line and those states to either side, that's where your cattle numbers are at. That's where the livestock's at. So, you know, we're trying to cover that and service and do the best job we can for the producer.
I'm sure it's a very competitive market, and you guys are always coming up with new improvements and improvising and to stay ahead of the game and on that topic as well.
You bet. We try to keep, you know, being a smaller company, you know, with just a family-owned deal, you know, we've got 9 salesmen that are on the road. You know, we're all the time. The product that you're going to get is going to be pretty fresh product. You know, it'll probably have been cooked within 30 days of you getting it. So we seasonally adjust our cook for the summertime and wintertime. Harder tubs in the summer, softer in the wintertime. And we're always looking one step ahead, you know, just to stay going in the future.
Is there a tub that is more popular than others with cattle producers, or does it kind of change on the season?
You know, our number one tub is kind of the flagship tub of MLS. It's an 18% protein, all natural, no urea or feather meal or anything like that in it. It's got a complete dose of vitamin and minerals, a little kick of protein to it, good fat content. It's going to get your cattle all the all the supplementation they need, you know, on grass. Also got an Aspergillus oryzae that's going to aid in the bugs production in the cow's gut. It's going to make them digest and utilize the forage if they're getting better. So if the forage is tough, you got them on corn stalks or bean stubble like that, this tub's going to excel even more.
Again, Mid-Continent Livestock Supplements, they've got protein tubs for cattle, horses, sheep, goats, all types of livestock, and you can find out more by going to mlstubs.com. Another thing with protein tubs I've noticed over the years, and this has become kind of a thing that people have utilized too, they've got softer, harder, the softer ones, of course, cattle can consume that faster. The harder ones stay out there a little longer. Do you guys have those same type of options also?
You bet. We cook a harder tub in the summertime and then a softer tub in the wintertime. And also the diameter of our tub helps control consumption. Like our number one tub is good for 35 to 50 head of cattle. So you can put one tub out for that. You got a smaller group than that, you can put a 125-pound tub out for that. Just the surface area and what we lease is in a day, by the humidity in the air, by the cows licking it. An inch of it weighs on the 200-pound an average of 15 pounds. So, you know, just by how many head you've got, what the size tub you want to put out. So.
And, of course, another nice feature of the Mid-Continent Livestock Supplement product, too, is they're weatherproof. Now, folks around here in the four states haven't had to deal with any snow for quite a while. We're not dealing with much rain right now either, but for folks in northern Midwest or in an area where it's going to be wetter, the weatherproof is a really nice feature to have because you're not going to have to worry about things dissolving away on you.
Right. You're not going to have to worry about that. You're not going to have to worry about the wind blowing your mineral away. You're not going to have to worry about any heat degradation or anything by the UV degradation in the minerals and things like that. It's all encapsulated, and by the molasses encapsulating that mineral particle, same way with the fly control and things like that, and by the molasses encapsulating that, it keeps the oxygen from it, so you can't get any degradation from it.
Well, you've had a busy week on the road. Where are you going to be traveling coming up in the next few weeks where people might be able to see you and visit with you?
You know, we're going to be at several of your events. I'll be in Lebanon here this next week with you guys, and then we'll see. Outside of that, I'll be in Iowa and Kansas and in Missouri, too. So.
You're going to be all over the place. So, well, Jeff, we do appreciate your time today. Thank you so very much for coming by and visiting with us and give us some more information and detail about Mid-Continent Livestock.
We appreciate it. We appreciate what you guys are doing here.
Again, you can find them an ad and contact information for Jeff and the rest of the sales staff and just in general about Mid-Continent Livestock Supplements just on the inside cover of the Seven Barns in 7 Days Stockman's Record Book. That'll be showing up at your area livestock markets over the next couple of weeks, and we do appreciate Jeff coming by and visiting with us. We're going to send it back to the station here, let you hear some more from our sponsors, check in with one of the Brownfield reports as we continue live on the road here today, Fort Scott, Kansas, at the Fort Scott Livestock Auction, as we kick off our Seven Barns in 7 Days tour here on KRMO Ag Source Radio.
Clear.
Okay.
Okay. That last one, there was quite a bit of audio dropping, and it seemed like that auctioneer was competing.
Hey folks, Sean here at the Concrete Works. We're located at the end of the rainbow, and we do things the old-fashioned way. We mine our own gravel, we batch our own concrete, we build our own custom forms, and every day we put the concrete into the forms. Your cattle will be happy campers eating out of our field bunks, line bunks, wide J bunks, commodity feed bunks, and freeze-proof stock tanks, too. We'll bring them to your farm on our own locomotive, and remember, folks, that ain't no bull.
Hey, Janet. Okay, now, can you hear me now? Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, I'm losing you. Let me mess with this.
Okay.
Okay, there you are.
I'm going to play a closing.
You're going to play what?
I was going to play a closing farm break, which is 2 minutes if you're having issues.
Okay, that's okay. Yeah, that guy I'm supposed to talk to is actually the guy that's auctioneering right now, so it's going to be just a minute before he gets here, so that'll work. I lost you because the Y on the flip jack got knocked out, and then I couldn't hear you anymore. I'll see how long he's going to be. I can actually come back on and...
Okay.
Just kind of refresh everybody what's going on. And then because Randall came up and the guy that's auctioneering right now wasn't supposed to get on the microphone. Okay.
Ready in 3, 2, and 1.
Welcome back once again to Fort Scott, Kansas. Sammy Clapper along with you here this afternoon as we've moved into the noon hour here on AM 990 Ag Source Radio. We're live on the road, Fort Scott Livestock Market, our first of our 7 barns in 7 days. We kicked off the 7 barns in 7 days tour today, and we are here in Fort Scott. It is sale day. And then next Monday, we'll be at Joplin Regional. Next Wednesday, we'll head down to Green Forest, Arkansas. Next Thursday, we'll head up I-44 to Lebanon. And then we go to Springdale, Arkansas next Friday. And then the 15th, we'll be over at the Springfield Livestock Marketing Center. And then the 16th, we'll wrap up the 7 barns in 7 days at Coffeyville, Kansas, at the Coffeyville Livestock Market. But things getting started today here with the 7 barns in 7 days tour. You can find the Stockman's Record Special Edition, 7 barns in 7 days. At your local sale barns. We've got them here today at Fort Scott, and you'll be seeing those show up in the next couple of weeks at all the sale barns throughout the four-state region. Special pages added to include VFD information with the new veterinary feed directive guidelines and regulations that went into effect at the first of the year. There's pages to include that information to go along with all your cow-calf data, your breeding records, your calving information, all right there, your Stockman's Record book from KRMO Ag Source Radio. And we've got them live, hot off the press here today in Fort Scott. And they'll be showing up at the other sale barns throughout the area as our very own Dwayne Gandy on the road delivering as many as he can, as fast as he can. And we do appreciate his help with that. Not only are we live here today on AM 990 Ag Source Radio, also streaming live audio today at RadioTalon.com. And we're also streaming live video today as well. You can find the live video a couple of different places. You can go to KRMO.com, click on the Farming in the Four States logo, and then find a link to our web TV channel. Or you can go to CityLinkTV.com and search for the Farming in the Four States channel in the Missouri section. So several ways to view the video, live streaming video today here at Fort Scott, Kansas, of the livestock auction. Currently, they are selling bulls. Their selling order of livestock start with the slaughter cows, and then they go to the bred cows and pairs. Then they get to the breeding bulls, and that is where they are at right now. They are selling breeding bulls here at Fort Scott, and then they will continue with the calves and yearlings and the highline cattle and continue on through the rest of the afternoon. And we appreciate the folks for all the hospitality. Randall Rediger, the GM here at Fort Scott, said they'll probably be selling cattle all the way till about 5 or 6 this evening. Right now, those selling bulls, and we were going to try to talk with Larry, the auctioneer, who is currently on the microphone. You can probably hear him in the background, but he got sidetracked, and he was on his way around here to visit with us in the sale ring, and somebody hollered at him to start selling bulls. So he is actually on the microphone right now, the auctioneer you can hear here on KRMO and Farming in the Four States Web TV. But as soon as he gets through with this run of bulls, he's going to come up and visiting with us. He is part of the family that runs Fort Scott Livestock Market, and we'll be looking forward to talking with him a little bit as well. Again, Fort Scott Livestock Auction, the fourth largest market in Kansas and one of the largest here in our area. And they've been in business since 1994, and they've marketed over 2 million head of cattle since their opening back in 94. Auctions every Saturday. They got feed and water pens, trucking arrangements, on-farm appraisals. They check in Friday nights. They load or unload 7 days a week. They can also help you with your tax income deferrals. And they do video auctions as well. They've got the auctions on dvauctions.com. That's dvauctions.com. So you can check out everything going on here at Fort Scott every Saturday. They're not only right here in the middle of the four states, but also right here on the eastern edge of the Flint Hills region of Kansas, where you'll find thousands and thousands of acres of cattle country, and many of those cattle come right here to Fort Scott to be marketed. Four generations here at the Fort Scott Livestock Market working for you. They've got a special cow sale coming up next Thursday, March the 9th, beginning at 6 p.m. Rockin' R Ranch will have a complete dispersal. Some of the livestock that included will be 15 black fall pairs, 120 black and red cows with 75 calves. The balance are springers. Also consigned 45 black cows, 3 to 6 years old in the second period, bred to black bulls. They've got 15 black cows, solid to broken mouth, third period. Then they've got several bulls that will be offered in the sale as well on Thursday, March the 9th. Five pasture-raised ET bulls. They've got some Limflex bulls, Black Angus bulls as well. And that will all be part of that special cow and bull sale Thursday, March the 9th, 6 p.m. here at the Fort Scott Livestock Market. You can find out more by going online, fslivestock.com. That's fslivestock.com. And you can find a little short bio about Fort Scott Livestock Market in our 7 Barns in 7 Days Stockman's Record Book. We've got information, contact information, and you can also like them on Facebook as well. And we've got that information right there in our 7 Barns in 7 Days Stockman's Record Book that you'll be finding at your local sale barn coming up here in the next couple of weeks. We've already started delivering those, so look for them and ask for them by name when you head to your local livestock barn. The Stockman's Record Special 7 Barns in 7 Days edition from KRMO Ag Source Radio. Not only all the information that you can compile in there and keep track of, but also page after page of sponsor advertisements that can help improve and enhance your operation, and they'll be more than happy. We were visiting with Jeff Anslinger from Mid-Continent Livestock Supplements. They've got low-moisture protein tubs, and we were appreciating him coming by and visiting with us, and you can find out more about them in our Stockman's Record Book as well. Well, it looks like Larry's jumped off the microphone. They've got another auctioneer in, so maybe he's making his way up here to our broadcast perch here in the sale ring. We're live at Fort Scott, Kansas, right here in the sale ring, as you've been hearing the auctioneer working throughout the morning. Looks like they've got the bulls sold, and now they're going on to the calves and the yearlings. This is right up Daisy's alley. She could have herself a little pet and take one home with her, as they've got a little, about 150-pound calf in there right now that they're selling. And again, you can view that on our website at Farming in the Four States channel from either off our KRMO.com page or CityLinkTV.com as well. We're going to send it back to the studios and get some words from our sponsors, as well as maybe a brownfield report. And then Larry, hopefully, will be able to work his way up here to our broadcast position to visit with us a little bit about Fort Scott Livestock right after this.
Clear.
Okay. Well, he's
that was funny. Daisy could take home one.
Yeah. Well, she was saying a while ago, we were out in the parking lot, and there was some in the trailer, and she goes, oh, look, she goes, some babies, and they were like 500-600 pounders, and I said, those aren't babies. I said, well, I guess actually in age they're probably babies because they're probably only a year or so old, but I said, those are like 500-600 pounders. I said, you want one of those little bitty ones that you can kind of run around your backyard. And one of those just got run into the sale ring. He was about 150 pounds, a little calf came in, so.
Oh, like, they are cute.
Yeah, he was like the size of a big dog, so.
That was funny.
Because they had a couple come in earlier. They had a couple of longhorn cattle come in with the big sets of horns. And she was like, oh, my gosh, look at the horns on that thing.
I know.
I said, yeah, you don't want to mess with one of those.
Now, that would make me nervous, being out in the field.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to be getting those cattle up and working them and stuff.
Jeez.
Because 99% of the time, they're probably just as calm and docile as any other cow, but then the one time that you get one that wants to get a little ornery, he's got some pretty impressive weapons there on top of his head.
Absolutely. You know.
He doesn't just have to, I mean, the worst case scenario is if he stabs you and gores you with one of them. But, I mean, as long as they are and as big as they are, he just got to sling his head around. He'd knock you down. It'd be like getting hit with a tree.
Right. No kidding. I mean, they really are just ominous looking.
Yeah.
Okay.
But he's getting closer.
Oh, that's fine. That's just because we also have that ag headline news that was a closer from yesterday, and okay. You know, so.
I was going to say, I was cleaning that out for you. You can sit in it.
Hey, I like that chair. I got this for when I have a back surgery.
All right. Let you set up with this. I appreciate you taking time to do this. So we'll just visit a little bit about the market, family, and how long you've been in business and stuff like that. Talk a little bit about how things are going today and stuff. That was Larry Martin.
Larry Martin.
Gotcha. And it's you and your family, right?
Yeah, my dad was selling
earlier.
Okay.
Running. How much time is left now, Janet?
Okay, we're on the Wydell ad and it's 28 seconds.
Okay. Sammy Clapper back with you, Farm of the Four States here on KRMO AM 990 Ag Source Radio. And we're live here today at the Fort Scott Livestock Market. And, go ahead and pop one off one ear there. There, give yourself, because it's going to pick up him. So we're going to be visiting with Larry Martin here in just a moment. We do appreciate him taking time to visit with us. And part of our Seven Barns in 7 Days tour that kicks off today here in Fort Scott, Kansas. And we do appreciate all the folks from Fort Scott Livestock Market for having us up today. Sale got started around 8 o'clock this morning. They're going to continue selling cattle through the afternoon. And, Larry, you've already been on the microphone doing a little auctioneering today. First of all, I guess let's just talk a little bit about Fort Scott Livestock Market, how long you've been in business. And, of course, it is a family-owned and operated business.
The second time around, my grandfather owned this barn back in the 50s and 60s. My dad and his partner owned it from in the 60s to... in the late 70s. They built this barn here in 70 or 71. They sold it to another individual, and then we took it back over in 1994. So we've had two or three hitches at it for the family for over the years.
Yeah, and you and I were talking before we jumped on the air, 4 generations of the Martin family running the auction here. So
yeah,
it's stayed in the family and just continued to pass
it
on.
It keeps going, just passing it on. No, but we can't do anything else. We never learned how to do anything else. So
and I was talking to Randall earlier and then visiting with you before we jumped on the air. There's a lot of you working right here, the sale ring right now.
Oh, everybody's, it's all family. We all work here, so this is kind of it.
You guys stay very, very busy. Sale every Saturday. You're right here on the edge of the Flint Hills where a lot of cattle are raised and then marketed through you guys. Over 2 million head have been run through here just in the last 15 years.
Yeah, it's always been a kind of a natural feed, you know, it feeds out 54 Highway, feeds from the Missouris, right on out in the Flint Hills there. So it's been kind of a natural.
And so far what I've been seeing here today, a wide variety of cattle too. Lots of different breeds you see coming through here.
Yeah, you know, there's a lot of good cattle around this part of the country. You know, you got the good blacks, good Charolais, and, you know, crossbreds. You know, we started this morning on these cows and bulls, and, you know, we'll sell about 400 cows and bulls, and then we'll get about 3,000. We'll get on these feeders. We'll have about 3,000 altogether today. So.
And, of course, you're on DV Auction, so people, if they don't have the opportunity to actually make it here to the livestock auction, they can view it online and bid online.
That's right. View us on DV Auction.
And that's one thing, the technology, just no longer than you guys have had it since 94, the advancements in technology with livestock markets, it's just crazy what you can do today to get the word out.
Yeah, 94, we didn't even have a cell phone in 94 when we started. Now you can see how much technology has advanced since then.
Prices starting to come back up in the cattle market. Had a little dip there at the end of 2016, but now in 2017.
Had a little dip there through last fall and winter, and it's got a lot, you know, it's getting better.
Are you seeing the numbers stay pretty steady?
Numbers have been good. The grass demand's really good, you know, this time of year. So
Yeah, and that's one thing. Hopefully the rain will come and we can keep that grass growing.
You're right. If we get a little shower, we'll be in good shape.
I know. Down in southwest Missouri where we're located, we've been very dry down in there. You guys have got a couple of rains that we haven't, but still it's dry up in this part of the country, too.
It's dry out west, too. I mean, western Kansas, the wheat out there, I think it's pretty sorry. I don't think there's only wheat out in western Kansas irrigated, I think. Most of it's dried up, so.
You guys have a lot of features here for the livestock producer at Fort Scott as well. I mean, they can bring their cattle in during the week. You unload on Friday nights. You got the feed and water pens to take advantage of that. So there's lots of different options that you offer.
Yeah, and we're building some more pens, if you saw as we're coming in there. But, yeah, you can bring them in during the week. We'll take care of them. You know, we also got deferred payments through the end of the year for your tax deals. And we also got a video option, too, you know, on your pot loads of cattle. So we can sell video options, too.
One thing coming up next week, too, you got a special cow and bull sale coming up. A lot of good cattle coming in on that one.
Yeah, we got an estate, kind of an estate deal at Rockin' R Ranch. They're dispersing an estate, and they're getting all them cows. Them are the two deals here, the Rockin' R and his Crone Brothers. That's a guy bought a bunch of cows and leased the pasture, and they sold the pasture on him. So now he doesn't have any place to put them, so we're going to have to disperse both deals of those cows there this week. So. Yeah, so, pretty nice dispersal.
Right, and every now and then, if you, like we said, your regular sales always on Saturday, but you'll have these special sales
we'll
every now and then.
We'll have these sales about once a month on the special cow sales usually through the fall and spring.
One thing for folks in this area, what do you want to pass along to them to let them know about what you can do for them here at Fort Scott?
Well, I mean, as you can see here, I mean, we got a lot of good, I mean, our customers, we got great customers. And we got a lot of good buyers. I mean, you can see here, I mean, there's a lot of people here and a lot of buyers here. I mean, so, you know, instead of you go to some places, you see three or four guys here. Well, you know, we got five or six cow buyers and bull buyers here this morning. And, you know, you'll have 20 different guys buying these calves this afternoon, you know, going from Iowa, Nebraska to western Kansas, you know. So, I mean, it's you know, we got a lot of good buyers. That's why we appreciate their business.
Yeah, you've grown to the fourth largest livestock market here in Kansas, and that shows the type of numbers that you have running through here every week.
Yeah, it just gets a little bigger all the time. So, you know.
And even though you're right here in Fort Scott, you're conveniently located. It's easy in and out. You got a big area for whether you've got a small trailer or a semi trailer, you can get in and out and unload and load easy.
It don't matter if you got 5 or 50. We'll get them sold for you.
What seems to be bringing some of the top prices today? Some of the top prices today, what
size?
I mean,
you know, them bulls, you know, sold on them slaughter bulls today, you know, 105, 106.7, and them cows in the 60s and 70s. And, you know, you'll sell some of these five-weight steers today in the 160, 170 range, you know, on that grass demand. So, you know, it'll be pretty good.
Well, we're looking forward to a nice spring, and cattle producers I know are looking forward to getting the grass growing as well.
You bet. We're ready for a rain.
Well, we sure appreciate all the hospitality and having us up today, and we'll let you get back to work.
Hey, we appreciate you guys, too. Thanks for coming up.
Larry Martin from Fort Scott Livestock Market visiting with us here today. He's been working the microphone auctioneering already today, and we're going to let him get back to work, but we do appreciate his time. We're going to take a quick break and be back more from Fort Scott, Kansas right after this.
Hey folks, Sean here at the Concrete Works. We're located at the end of the rainbow, and we do things the old-fashioned way. We mine our own gravel, we batch our own concrete, we build our own custom forms, and every day we put the concrete into the forms. Your cattle will be happy campers eating out of our field bunks, line bunks, wide J bunks, commodity feed bunks, and freeze-proof stock tanks, too. We'll bring them to your farm on our own locomotive, and remember, folks, that ain't no bull.
Okay. The Superior Lamar cell's running. We've got about 25 seconds.
Okay.
And then after you, after we come out of, when you send it back to me, we're going to go to Compton, right?
Yes. I'll just do a quick little thing and then say we'll hear from our sponsor, one of our sponsors, and go to the Compton deal.
Okay. 5 seconds. Ready, and 3, 2, and 1.
Back with you once again, Fort Scott Livestock Market. Sammy Clapper here on KRMO AM 990 Ag Source Radio. We're live on the road as we kick off our 7 Barns in 7 Days tour today here in Fort Scott, Kansas. Sale day at the livestock market in Fort Scott. They got started early this morning. Right now they're moving into some of the yearlings. And we're looking at somewhere 400 to 500 pounders right now being sold, and they're going to be continuing selling cattle throughout the rest of the afternoon. Of course, we're going to be with you until 1 o'clock here on AM 990 as part of the Farming in the Four States special edition here on a Saturday on the road with 7 Barns in 7 Days. And we're going to continue to remind you, don't forget to look for the 7 Barns in 7 Days edition of the Stockman's Record Book when you're at your favorite sale barn. Dwayne Gandy is out delivering those, and he'll continue to be delivering those at sale markets throughout the four-state region over the next week or two. We're going to be dropping them off when we visit the stockyards next week in Joplin, Green Forest, Arkansas, Springdale, Arkansas, and Lebanon, Missouri. And then the following week, we'll be out in Coffeyville, Kansas, in the Springfield Livestock Marketing Center. So lots to do here. 7 Barns, 7 Days tour kicking off today. And we are live on the road, Fort Scott, Kansas, at the Fort Scott Livestock Market. Right now, we're going to let you hear from some of our sponsors of our 7 Barns in 7 Days tour. We've got a lot of interviews with our sponsors that are helping support this tour. They all have products that either deal with livestock, with ag. They also have different types of technology and products that can help enhance and improve your operations. And we're going to be visiting with all of those folks. And if you have to deal with insurance, as we all have to deal with at some time, we've got some talk from some of those folks as well. We're going to be playing those interviews for you on all of our stops of the 7 Barns in 7 Days tour. Right now, since we are here on the edge of the Flint Hills and in cattle country, we're also here in East Central Kansas and West Central Missouri, where a lot of row crop operations are in place as well. And whether you're dealing with crops or whether you're dealing with forage for your livestock, sometimes you may have to look at adding irrigation into your operation. So we're going to hear right now with the folks from Compton Irrigation out of Lamar, Missouri.
Clear. interview.
Yes, or yeah, the interview, yeah.
Phone on. Let me think about this. Oh. If I put it on broadcast and pull you back, it should be.
I think it would, wouldn't it?
Why don't we try it?
Okay.
Why don't you not say anything and let me try that.
Okay.
Let me see. I know what I can do.
Hey folks, Sean here at the Concrete Works. We're located at the end of the rainbow, and we do things the old-fashioned way. We mine our own gravel, we batch our own concrete, we build our own custom forms, and every day we put the concrete into the forms. Your cattle will be happy campers eating out of our field bunks, line bunks, wide J bunks, commodity feed bunks, and freeze-proof stock tanks, too. We'll bring them to your farm on our own locomotive, and remember, folks, that ain't no bull.
Clear. Okay.
Did you say something, Janet?
I'm getting, hold on just a second. Okay, I'm running a Sawyers and Son ad, 26 seconds.
Okay. So did the Compton irrigation run then?
Yes.
Okay.
It's done.
Okay.
I wasn't sure how to do it. You know, I had it on broadcast, and then I shut it off, and that's when I jumped to this. We've got 5 seconds. Do you want to take it back? Do you want me to run another ad?
Run another ad, please.
All right.
Yeah, because that's one thing I completely forgot. We're not using this the same way as we do for ball games. So to get the feedback through our headsets, so we can get that audio going out over web TV. Gonna have to try to figure that out Monday. The only thing I can think of is like when you're talking to me right now on the phone, you just have to put the phone by the speaker and turn the speaker up, but that would be kind of a pain.
Oh, I can do whatever you want us to do. Another thing I thought of is having the audio files on a flash drive that Daisy could play while I'm playing them.
Oh, yeah.
Or stick it up on the laptop. I don't know how that would work. We've got 5 seconds. Do you want me to run another one?
No, that'll be okay. I'll take it back, and then we'll play that Big John ad, or the Big John interview.
All right. Ready? And 3, 2, and 1.
Sammy Clapper back with you here from Fort Scott, Kansas. We are live on the road today, part of our 7 Barns in 7 Days tour at Fort Scott Livestock Market. And we are very thankful to be able to get things up and running. And we appreciate you being with us here today for a special Saturday edition of Farming the Four States on AM 990 Ag Source Radio. We're also streaming live video today of the auction going on in Fort Scott. A lot of cattle coming through today. They're expecting somewhere around 2,500 to 3,000 head. And they are currently, they went through the cows and bulls, and now they're on to the calves, yearlings, and mid-range livestock. And they've got several offerings coming through right now as they'll be selling cattle all day long here in Fort Scott. Thanks to Randall Rediger, the general manager, and Larry Martin, one of the owners, for visiting with us today. We appreciate their courtesy and hospitality today. I know it's a busy day on sale day, but we appreciate their time as they helped us out here today getting set up and ready to go. We're going to play another interview for you from one of our sponsors of the 7 Barns in 7 Days tour. And we're going to hear from Big John Manufacturing. Now, Big John Manufacturing, they have a wide variety of ag-related products. And we're going to hear from Big John Manufacturing right now, and then we'll be back here at Fort Scott, Kansas, right after this interview from Big John Manufacturing.
Clear.
Okay. What time do you have right now on your computer clock?
12:48.
Okay.
And we've got 8 minutes and 40 seconds left in this.
Okay, this will be good. This will get us right up to the 1 o'clock hour then.
Okay. The only thing I could think of is where Daisy would have those audio files, we'd copy them down and stick them on her laptop.
Right. Okay, I'll say something to her and see how that would work for her, see if that'll work pretty good, because that would be an easy deal to do.
Yeah. She could control it on her end, and we could control it, you know. And I also thought, just after this is done, when we've got all the web TV posted, having those audio files posted on the KRMO.com.
Oh, yeah, so people could go in and listen to them, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Put in is what you'll get out.
One thing I noticed on your website as well, and again, we encourage people to check it out, bigjohnmfg.com, is the saddle tank that you produce for spray rigs. And a lot of grain and row crop producers, they like to go through to make the one pass, and the saddle tanks on the tractors, when they go through and plant and spray and do everything in one sweep that way. And you guys make some of the largest saddle tanks I've ever seen.
Yeah, we do. The small ones are, you know, a couple hundred gallons per site, up to 600 gallons per site, a total of 1,200 gallons.
Hey folks, Sean here at the Concrete Works. We're located at the end of the rainbow, and we do things the old-fashioned way. We mine our own gravel, we batch our own concrete, we build our own custom forms, and every day we put the concrete into the forms. Your cattle will be happy campers eating out of our field bunks, line bunks, wide J bunks, commodity feed bunks, and freeze-proof stock tanks too. We'll bring them to your farm on our own locomotive, and remember folks, that ain't no bull.
That way, or do you also deal some of your products through dealerships?
We, in certain areas, we do both. It kind of depends on the area, but if if you got an interest in some of our products or a question on something, just give us a call here, and we'll help you through it. We'll direct you to where somebody that can help you.
Again, as you were mentioning, over 40 years in business, a wide variety and range of agricultural products, very useful for just about anyone in the ag industry, whether it's livestock, whether it's row crop, whatever the case may be. You can find something that will definitely be able to be utilized in your operation from Big John Manufacturing. Mr. Prince, again, we appreciate your time very much for visiting with us today, and we encourage people to get online, Big John MFG, and check out your products.
And we sure thank you there, and enjoy visiting with all your audience.
All right, thank you very much, and we will get back to regular programming here on KRMO Ag Source Radio.
All right, I'm playing a Jansen Rand Angus ad, 25 seconds, and then I'll give a countdown out of it. Sammy? Sammy? Sammy?
Okay, I'm back.
Okay. 5 seconds.
Okay.
3, 2, and 1.
All right, back with you here from Fort Scott Livestock Market in Fort Scott, Kansas, our kickoff day of our Seven Barns in 7 Days tour here on KRMO Ag Source Radio. Live here on the road today with a special Saturday edition of Seven Barns in 7 Days and Farming in the Four States. We'll be back with you next week. We visit 4 barns next week. We go to Joplin on Monday, Green Forest, Arkansas on Wednesday, Lebanon on Thursday, and then back to Arkansas, Springdale, next Friday. And then the following week on Wednesday the 15th, we go to Springfield Livestock Marketing Center and then Coffeyville, Kansas on the 16th to wrap up our 7 barns in 7 days. We've enjoyed the day here at Fort Scott. We appreciate all the folks here for all the hospitality, and we look forward to visiting the other sale barns as part of our 7 barns in 7 days tour that kicks off today here on AM 990. Again, a special Saturday edition of Farming the Four States here on KRMO Ag Source Radio. It's a really nice day here throughout the four state region as we got the tour kicked off, and we look forward to visiting the other places next week. Before we get out of here today and get you on to the next hour here on AM 990, we want to thank all the folks here at Fort Scott Livestock Market, the Martin family, and in particular Larry Martin for coming up and visiting with us. Also, Randall Rediger, the general manager here at Fort Scott Livestock Market. We appreciate his help today as well. And all of our sponsors that have helped support this 7 Barns in 7 Days tour. You'll find them mentioned in the 7 Barns in 7 Days Stockman's Record Book. You'll also hear them advertised on AM 990. And we'll be playing interviews from many of those. We heard a couple of interviews today from Big John Manufacturing and Compton Irrigation. Jeff Anslinger from Mid-Continent Livestock Supplements was actually here today, and he visited with us live on the air. He is one of our sponsors as well, and we'll be hearing more of those interviews coming up over the next week, week and a half, as we visit the sale barns around the four-state region. And we appreciate our sponsors so very much for helping support our ag programming on KRMO AM 990. Dwayne Gandy's out delivering the Stockman's Record Books to all the sale barns throughout the area, so be looking for those, and if they don't have them yet, ask, and we'll see if we can swing some by that area. 7 Barns in 7 Days special edition of the Stockman's Record. All types of information inside, ads from our sponsors, and then plenty of pages for data record keeping for your livestock operation, breeding records, calving records. Also, there's a gestation table in there. New VFD pages have been added as well to keep track of your veterinary feed directive guidelines and regulations. Those are in there also. Information about the sale barns throughout the four-state region, sale dates and contact information. And then our 7 barns, we have a special section in the back of the book that has bios about each one of those livestock markets, a little history and some of the information about each sale barn we'll be visiting over the course of the next week and a half. So a great tool to use with your livestock operation, the Stockman's Record from KRMO AM 990, and this special 7 Barns in 7 Days edition. Thanks to Janet for running the board for us back at the studios and getting us on the air today, and Daisy for coming along with me today. Get us up on the web, as she's been streaming live video today, and she'll be posting some of the happenings today here at Fort Scott on our KRMO page, as well as our YouTube channel and our CityLink web TV channel. So lots of different ways to keep up with what's going on here on KRMO and our 7 Barns in 7 Days tour. We thank so much all of our sponsors for helping make this happen. And a big thank you again today to the Martin family here at Fort Scott, Kansas, for all their hospitality and courtesies today, as we've had a fun time. And one thing we did not get to do yet, and don't know whether we'll get to before we get out of here or not, one thing that is famous with sale barns and livestock markets is their cafes. And it's a little-known gem to all the cattle producers in the four state regions about how wonderful the cafes are at all of these sale barns. People don't think about them having great cafes and restaurants. They just think about them selling cattle and livestock, but they all have wonderful cafes. And I hear that the Fort Scott Livestock Market Cafe is famous for their pies. So we might have to check and see what kind of pies they have down there. But everyone has their own specialties, because if you're going to spend the day at the livestock market buying and selling cattle, you got to have a good place to eat as well. So we'll be looking forward to checking out some of those cafes over the next week and a half or so as well. But that's going to do it today. 7 Barns in 7 Days kicking off today here at Fort Scott, Kansas. Again, if you are in west central Missouri or east central Kansas, they can handle your livestock marketing needs. and just give them a call or find them online at fslivestock.com. That's fslivestock.com. They're also on Facebook. They've got their auctions streamed live on DV Auctions, and their sale is every Saturday. They've got feed and water pen, trucking arrangements, on-farm appraisals, and they also can do income deferral contracts to help with your tax planning. And they sell all types of cattle right here at Fort Scott, Kansas. Don't forget, next Thursday, they've got a special cow and bull sale. And that's next Thursday, March the 9th, here at Fort Scott, beginning at 6 p.m. A couple of dispersals from Rockin' R Ranch and Crone Brothers. And they've got a lot of offerings, over 120 black and red cows with 75 calves. The balance are springers from Rockin' R Ranch. And then Crone Brothers has 100 black, red, and Charley Cross cows, 80 with calves, and the rest are springers. And then they've also got several offerings of bulls as well. 5 pasture-raised ET bulls, 3 Limflex bulls, a couple of black Angus bulls, and that's all part of the special cow and bull sale next Thursday, March the 9th at 6 p.m. here at Fort Scott, Kansas. And then their regular Saturday sale begins around 8 o'clock, between 8 and 8:30 every Saturday here at the Fort Scott Livestock Market. So look for the 7 Barns and 7 Days Stockman's Record Book. We are delivering them now at your local sale barn, and we'll continue delivering those over the next week or so. And we'll be back with you Monday, right before the noon hour, for a Farming in the Four States Monday edition at Joplin Regional Stockyards. And we'll be over there visiting with those folks, and we hope you join us then as we continue with our 7 Barns and 7 Days tour. Well, that's going to do it today from Fort Scott. Again, thanks to everyone for the hospitality here today, and we'll look forward to being back with you Monday from Joplin Regional as 7 Barns and 7 Days continues here on KRMO Ag Source Radio, your ag voice of the four states.